Welcome. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here in this time of worship. Today is a special day for us to celebrate God's blessing. In addition to the beauty of the creation around us, today we gather to give thanks for our animals and God's love and care that we receive from them and want to share with them. Later in the service, we will invite you to introduce your pet, but if they aren't used to sitting for worship, please feel free to wander.
Morning. In 2009, a member of Ivanhoe Church wrote this poem about this tree we gather beneath. I am the tree.
I am the tree. I am the white oak tree that covers you in shade. Above your head, my leaves move in the breeze as soft blessings to the summer morning. My roots spread out beneath your feet, wider and deeper than the tree you see above the ground. For about 300 years, these roots have anchored me against the wind and storm. From this forest hilltop, I have watched this lush, rolling grassland come of age. I was a sapling when the great city of Chicago was only a lonely trading post. Long before white men ever even walked here, Native Americans hunted deer on this hill. To mark their trails, they bent my lowest branch so others in the tribe can find their way. Before this land became a nation, I heard the solitary songs of trappers and traders. I heard muskets crack and arrows sing as soldiers and indigenous died for this land. After the Kickapoo were pushed into the west, I heard the creaking wheels of heavy ox carts bringing families to farm these rich prairies. From the time this church first rose upon this hill, I listened to the prayers of this congregation. My branches lifted the hymns of your pioneers. Children from this church have played in my cool shade for 168 summers. As centuries passed, I became the tallest tree, the king of all of the white oaks on this hill. From my topmost branches, I could see villages become towns, barns turn into factories, horses give way to automobiles, and songbirds share the sky with speeding planes. Under my high banner of leaves, I watched my prairie kingdom change and grow. Then one stormy night, my tall, proud banner crashed to earth in a tangle of limbs and leaves, sliced away by a sliver dagger of lightning. In one sharp, stinging moment, the crown of my sturdy trunk was gone, and I was no longer the king of the white oaks. Now I cannot claim the royalty of nature that once was proudly mine. But each year I green and grow again. Birds and squirrels build nests in my branches, and children play about my rough bark trunk. Just as this little hilltop church has done, for longer than we can remember, I have survived to honor God. Please prepare yourselves for worship during the playing of the prelude.
Thank you.
the earth and everything on it, the world and all who live in it, belong to God. The universe comes from God and everything that lives in God. The glory of God will cover the earth as the waters cover the sea. Nothing happens outside of God's love. Everything is in God. Everything is one in God. Everything is one. Please stand if you are comfortably able and join us in our first hymn.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Animals are mentioned frequently in Scripture, as in these verses. In Proverbs 12, verse 10, the righteous know the needs of their animals. In Deuteronomy 22 and Exodus 23, if you see an animal that is overburdened, you should help to lighten its load. Animals are also included in Sabbath laws for rest. In Job 12:7, but ask the animals, and they will teach you, the birds of the air, and they will tell you. Animals were saved from the flood and afterwards made a part of the covenant with Noah. Genesis 9:9-10. A giant fish saved Jonah in Jonah 2:1-11. Ravens brought bread to Elijah in 1 Kings 17-6. Animals were included in God's concerns for saving Nineveh. And in their repentance, Jonah 3:7 and 4:11. And I believe animals share in Christ's redemption of all of God's creation. Let's join in this psalm of praise that creates God's creation and our role in caring for God's creation. O Lord, what variety you have created! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is filled with your creativity. How wonderful is the diversity of your creation! When you give food to them, they gather it up. When you open your hand, they are filled with good things.
All creatures depend on you to feed them.
May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May God rejoice in creation.
I will sing to you all my life.
I will make music for my God as long as I live. Please join us in the hymn, All Creatures of Our God and King.
Person and pet is like no other relationship, because the communication between fellow creatures is at its most basic. Eye to eye, a person and their pet are two creatures of love. No wonder people enjoy the opportunity to bring their animal companions to church for a special blessing. Church is the community where the bond of creatures is, where the bond of creation is celebrated. Let's begin our, we're gonna see who we have here today. Animals have come to be blessed. All right. So please tell us the name of your animal and any relevant information you'd like us to know.
This is Gertrude. She's like a little black tornado. and with Gladys, you know, now she has a pony. She's 4 months.
I can attest that's a very active time. I also have a 4-month-old I'm working with. All right, who do we have here?
Well, this is Rocky. And Rocky, many of you know, was Gil, my ring dog, when we got married. And it took a little bit of training for him, but when he realized there was a treat at the end of that trip, he was good. He's 8 years old, and he's our only pet.
This is Timothy James Thompson.
Three names.
And he's an excitable boy, they all said. He'll be 9 this month.
Wow. All right. Talk about. Oh, my goodness. Yeah.
Well, my husband posted a picture of my my cat on Facebook last night, which I think is a coincidence because he didn't realize that today is Pet Blessing Sunday. But Whiskey is 19 years old.
Wow.
And doing well. Been in remission of diabetes for 4 years, And if you have a cat that's suffering from that, talk to me because I think I found the way.
Some of you might remember several years back, we had my horse Maverick here at the Pet Blessing. He was not happy to be away from his friends, so he did not come today, but he looks a little bit like this, just darker. And he is 27, and he used to help me with Civil War reenacting. That's how I came across him.
This is my dog, Piggy. He's 14 years old. He was found at a gas station in Mississippi, 10 weeks old, and a great little dog.
I have Gibbs. We believe he's about 4.5 years old. He's a rescue. He's a great supporter of Fremont Library. He's eaten several other books. he's settled down and he's become a very good dog.
Maybe I'll jump in.
All right.
So we have two new pets. We have Buster. The cat is acquired off the street from a person in Wheeling who just happened across him. And he's got a voracious appetite, and we have a new puppy who loves to play tug of war, and she's only about a year old, and so she's a handful, loves to bark at everything that moves also. So.
Not want to come today with the other puppies. Willow is, let's see, she's named after Pussy Willow because she's gray and white. And Willow is 5 months old and she plays fetch and she likes rabbit flavored cat food.
Rabbit flavored? Yeah, we've done that before.
We have Misty and Dexter, who were litter mates, and we got them when they were 6 months old. They're 13 now. And Cobra, who is 8. And they're all really good pups. Misty, we've asked for prayers for her because she does have cancer again. But she's here with us now, and we wanted to bring her today, and thank you so much. And she had a steak dinner, compliments of Lexi and Colin last night.
Wow.
Did I miss anybody? All right. Well, let's bless these animals. Let's begin our time of prayer with a moment of silence to remember and give thanks for loved ones lost this year. Our lives are forever changed as a result of the companionship of our animal friends. Their love for us is unconditional and unending. And as they have crossed the rainbow bridge, we give thanks and remember them with love that is forever. Let us pray a blessing for animals. Holy God, you who created them and called them good, bless again these creatures who come to us as a blessing, fashioned of fur or feather or fin, formed of flesh that breathes with your own breath, that you have made from sheer delight, that you have given in dazzling variety. Bless them who curl themselves around our hearts and who twine themselves through our days, who companion us in our labor, who call us to come and play. Bless them who will never be entirely tamed and so remind us that you love what is wild, that you rejoice in what lives close to the earth, that your heart beats in the heart of these creatures that you have entrusted to our care. Guide us this day as we bless our companions, a small gesture in return for the love and care they have given us. May our relationships with them be a reflection of our love for you. We ask you, Holy God, to bless each pet and animal. We now ask that you grant our special animal companions your care and healing power to take away any suffering they have. Please keep them safe and protect them from harm. Give us, their human friends, a new understanding of our responsibilities to these creatures of yours and how we can experience your love and care through them. Amen. Please join me in rise if you are able, and join me for the hymn for the beauty of the earth. Thank you.
The first test, I walked up here without falling down. All right, time for any joys or concerns that any of us have here this morning. Yes, Mary?
I would like to raise a concern of joy. Yesterday, Doris Hamilton sponsored a musical event here at church, and it was just absolutely remarkable. You can ask Doris if we did make a copy. We didn't publish it because of copyright, but you could ask Doris if you wish, and miss the opportunity to be here.
So thanks to Doris for her musical program of yesterday. Had a note here that Gail Block let us know that she welcomed her first great-grandson, Luca, into the family on Thursday, the 29th.
All right.
Congratulations to Gail and her family. Yes?
Just want to mention that Marilyn, who always drives me, is not doing very well.
Oh.
She was in the hospital this week, and she's home now. And she just does not sound real perky, so a little card or something would certainly be influential. Thank you.
Any other concerns? Barry?
So Chuck and Diana Garrett, who have been attending church, Chuck had knee replacement surgery about 2 weeks ago. I've not been able to follow up and know how they're doing, but I know that they would appreciate your prayers.
Anyone else?
Sally.
Sally.
Prayers for my college. performing with.
So my dear friend Kathy, I mentioned my roommate from college. Please continue to pray for her as she continues treatment for cancer.
One of those holes is going to get me on one of those trips. Any other concerns? I did want to mention that to remember we have a suicide prevention class coming up on September 11th. So if you can help with that, that would be great. Any other things? So let's assume a posture of prayer. Creator Spirit, you know and love everything about us. You are aware of the ways of feeling and the sparks of thought throughout our days. You are mindful of our movements and actions, our work and our play, our leisure and our sleeping. We are held by you as you hold your creation. May we be attentive to your holding now and bask in your affirmation. We will raise you, for truly you are wonderfully made. We pray in the name of our Savior and with the words Christ taught us, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We love because God first loved us. We share because God first blessed us. We pray because God first believed in us and opened us to experiencing God's love. May what we love, what we share, and what we pray for help to build God's great community of love. We offer ourselves and our gifts for this building up. Please join me in a prayer of dedication. We dedicate ourselves anew, loving God, to be good stewards and care for creation. Amen. Now, remain standing for our final hymn, All Things Bright and Beautiful.
Life is short, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those who travel the way with us. So be swift to love and make haste to be kind. Also, don't forget to join us inside for delicious coffee hour items.